Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to go over how to create an image map. So image maps are pretty neat, and I haven't done one in a while, but they really do fulfill a great purpose. I got this photo here off of Flickr. It's a Creative Commons pick from X-Magician, and it's got a few hikers. It's got a couple of long-distance hikers on the Pacific Crest Trail and a day hiker. And whenever you have a photo with a group of people, you might start to think maybe an image map is the solution, and an image map would allow us to click on different people in this photo and be taken to, let's say, a bio page about them or something more specific. And it doesn't have to be people. So basically, an image map allows you to click on different parts of an image and get taken to a different web page. All right. So I've already got an image allocated here, and it's on my web page. So let's go ahead and get into the mapping. And I'll jump over to my editor, and you can see I've already got a bunch of stuff on there, including my fig caption and stuff like that. So whenever you want to use an image map, you're actually going to put in an attribute in your image tag called use map. And I'm going to go ahead and use map. I'll go ahead and just call this hikers. Okay, and I'm going to preference it with the pound sign there. So when I reference the name of my image map code. All right, and then later on the web page. Now, by the way, it doesn't have to be right after the image. It could be at the very bottom of the page or something like that. I'm going to create an area for my map. And I've got a set of opening and closing tags. Let me just put some spaces here so you can really be clear on what's going on. And I'm going to go ahead and name my map hikers. Okay, so my map name is hikers. My use map attribute, hikers, is going to reference this map. And within this set of map tags, I'm going to keep track of the areas in which people can click on. And to do that, I will be using area tags. And I'm going to be using three, since there's three different people in my photo that I want the visitor to be able to click on. So that's the basics right there. Now, of course, a really important part is inside of the area tag, you need the attributes, which will tell the browser what zones on this photo a visitor can click on. Okay. Now, to get this, let me go and put in the attributes first, and then we can kind of see how we can get the data for it. For area, there's a shape attribute, and then there's also going to be a coordinates attribute. And I mentioned in my image video, I like to use an alt attribute too. So I'm going to put some alternate text there, which will help people with a vision impairment. Of course, the shape is what it sounds like. There are several shapes you can do with an image map. There's a point, which I've never used in my life, and I can't think of why you'd want to do it. With point, it's literally one pixel, one point that you would have to click on. So that's not very useful. The rect shape, rectangle, is extremely common. In fact, if you don't use a shape attribute at all, it defaults to rectangle. So that's one, that one is used quite a bit. Circle, just what it sounds like. And poly, for any multi-sided polygon shape. Okay, so you could do something as simple as a triangle or something more complex as a decagon or something like that. So if I was literally making an image map out of, let's say, the United States, and I wanted each state to be a hot spot, a clickable area, then I would use a poly. And the more coordinates you use, the more defined you can get that shape. But ours is going to be pretty simple. So I'm going to talk about rectangles, the default, most common shape. And the coordinates I need, I'm going to need two sets of coordinates. I'm going to need the XY coordinates for the top left of the clickable zone and the XY coordinates for the bottom right of the clickable zone. So I'll get this gentleman up here in the front first. And to get my coordinates, I'm going to use my an online image editor, Pixlr, which I just used in another video. And I've got my image all loaded up, and I'm in my point mode here. And as I mouse over the image, if you look over to the top right of the screen up in this area, you're going to see the XY coordinates of my arrow. So if I go and just put my mouse somewhere roughly around here, above this gentleman, and I see the coordinates are 258, 123, 258, comma, 123. I need two sets, so I'm going to go ahead and find the bottom right. The bottom right, I'll go down here, and I see 381, 497. I'm looking over at the top right corner of the screen recording. You see that little XY? That's the location of my point on the photo. And let's see, I've got 393, 499, 393, 499, 393, 499. There we go. Oh, I forgot an extremely important attribute in here, of course, is href. Is where do I want the visitor to go when they click in this zone? For now, I'll just put google.com, and my alternate text is Hal the Hiker. You might put in their name in this area. But that's how we would create our image map. Now let's go ahead and test it out. So I'm going to go ahead and save this, jump back over to my browser, refresh, and you'll notice when I start to move my pointer over this first hiker, you notice I get my little hand there, which lets me know it's a hyperlink, and it's just over him in that invisible rectangle shape. When I click my mouse, and I'm holding my mouse button down, you can actually see in my Chrome browser a faint outline of where that image is, or where that hot spot is. And when I let go, of course, it's going to take me over to Google. So that's the basics of creating an image map. And of course, I would do something similar to make hot spots out of the second hiker, through hiker, and the day hiker over here.